Greetings all, Devious Monkey here. As you can see, a little bit of a change today. I decided that I needed to test this gear just a tad bit more and give you something different other than my black gothy outfit that I talked about having being the only thing that I own. It isn't. I own a bunch of clothing. I just choose not to wear it. What I did was I have changed things around a little bit, took my handy dandy drill, and I moved the lighting around in here. Lighting being the little green lamp with the hue bulb and my little magnifier lamp extension thingy. Basically, it's just a big magnification lens with a ring light around it so that my old eyes can see close-up shit because I can't see anything. But everything was just always in the wrong spot, and I've moved it around various places because I keep drilling it into this desk that I'm sitting at to make sure that it doesn't fall over, and it just wasn't in the right place. So now I moved the green light with the hue bulb up towards the front so that now I can actually have a 45 degree angle, as you can see, coming straight at me from over there, and the ring light magnifier is now on the little cubby thing that I built for the cat so he could look out the window, and it's away from the desk altogether. Now, the reason I started to do that because I thought, okay, I've been using the 18-105 lens on this cinema setup that I've got going on here because it's the most versatile lens that I have as far as zoom ranges, and it's also really good glass. It's an f4, and I thought, okay, let me try the 35mm 1.8 full frame lens on this. Well, I put that on there, and I had to move the tripod so far back that it's basically now in the office portion of this room instead of the studio portion, right up against the chair that I use at my desk. And it still was only getting like this much in there, and I could barely get the clock and so on and so forth, and it looked like shit. It was just too far away. So until I get that 20mm 1.8 full frame lens, we're sticking with the 18-105. The other thing that I did, because I was playing around with all the settings and the lights and everything, one thing that I had it on was auto ISO. It always wanted to go to 6400. Now, granted, it doesn't look bad, but I'm like, why does it seriously have to go up to 6400 every friggin' time? So I put it at 1600 and set it, and that's what I've been using the past few times, ever since I changed the lighting and made it all blue. And it looked okay. I mean, I think it looked great, actually, but I still felt like that was a little bit high. So I backed it all the way down to 400 and then turned the lights up, and it looked like shit. My skin tone got all messed up and harsh shadows and everything, and I just didn't like it. So I went to 800, and ultimately I settled right now, it's at 1,000. So I'm at shutter priority at 1/50th. The f-stop changes constantly, especially when I'm waving my hands around like a loon. But I put the ISO at 1,000. And I think, you know, I'm looking at the monitor, I think it looks pretty good. I have this one little like wang of hair here that keeps coming out, and I can see it on the monitor, and it's driving me crazy because I'm anal retentive and ADD and OCD and every other freaking letter in the alphabet. God damn it. I'm ready to like get scissors and cut that damn thing off. Okay, for now, I always say for now, as I'm looking at the frame on the Ninja, you can hear it. That's the little metal thingy that I have drilled into the wall to hold the curtains, the black curtains when I open them. Depending on which lens I was putting on here and how I had it set up, you could sometimes see that. If I put the curtain in that, you can see the curtains. So I have to get rid of that because I don't like that. Don't want you to see that. And I need it to block the blinds so that I have somewhat relatively uniform light in here. Everything else is set now. I'm sure I'll change it tomorrow. The other thing is I am one dealer short of finishing this ongoing work project. I got a lot done yesterday and today. So I have one dealer left, and he's supposed to text me and give me a verbal okay, and then I'm done with that damn project. Phew. I went outside today because I picked up some stuff that came in. That stuff being the Camvate quick release plate on the riser thingamajigger and the two 15mm carbon fiber small rig rods for the complete cinema build out. They came today, which is Thursday, and they weren't supposed to be here until tomorrow. Yay! Yay for getting shit quicker. I have ordered two more pieces for this. I went ahead and got the HDMI cable holder because the way that this is hooked up now, it's not actually holding the hard part of the cable, I have the cable bent back and it's literally squishing down on the cable, and I don't like that. So I'm gonna get the, I ordered the proper thing. That should be here sometime, maybe this weekend. I completed all of my research and decided exactly what power components I was gonna get to finish out this cinema build out. And it's no different than it was 3 days ago. I just cemented it in my head and justified everything in my head that I'm ordering the right pieces. So everything's from Indie Pro Tools, and that is a plate that has, it's a gold mount plate. Remember, gold mount, not V mount. So a gold mount plate that has the built-in dummy battery coming out for, well, the A6600, but A73 is what it says. It's built out for that. And then an additional D-tap cable for the Ninja. I also got a 95, yeah, I think it's a 95, maybe 98, but whatever, 95 watt hour battery. I did not go with the Micro Series because it was an additional $40. It really isn't any all that much smaller than the one that I'm getting, and whatever. So this is the first battery of many. But so I ordered that as well. And I also got a D-tap splitter. So it goes into the D-tap either on the plate, which has an additional D-tap connector, or the battery, and you plug it in there, and then it splits it into another D-tap plus a 5-volt USB. I decided to get that because, one, it isn't going to, essentially I'm not going to be taking up a D-tap port because it gives me one, so I can plug whatever I need to plug into that, but because it gives me that USB, now I can run that over to my Rode Wireless Go receiver. So this way I can have it, I can plug it in, and I won't run out of power on that. Once I get this set up, it will have, oh, and I got a charger as well, of course. I had to get a charger for the battery. And I thought that it was supposed to come with a free charger, but it was one of those you just sort of plug it in and it takes 18 years. But whatever, I got one and should be able to charge the battery up completely in about three and a half hours, which is nothing in my world. That will complete this cinema rig build out with my A6600. Then I will go through and I will show you the build out and link all the parts and pieces and show you how I have it all set up. It's been growing and changing over the past couple of days. It'll change a little bit more once I get that HDMI holder because I'm gonna have to switch things around, I think. It'll all be done. It will be perfect and I will be a filming fool. That stuff, I think, is not supposed to get here until next Wednesday. So it's gonna be a week, at least, before I get it. Just forget about the cinema rig build out and I'll stop talking about it after today until I get everything put together and make the actual video. Just to follow up, it is 94 degrees out right now. It's been hot as balls all day. Heat, humidity, sunshine, it's been going. I only went outside to go pick up the package to confirm, in fact, that it is hot as balls outside. And I have been sitting in my office since this morning about 8:30 and I didn't even turn a fan on. And it has been absolutely pleasant. Had this not been done, given the situation right now, it would have already been sweltering hot in here before I even walked into the room for the first thing in the morning. So the fact that it is so pleasant in this heat and humidity, hell yeah, I'll take it. It's perfect. No additional sound, no additional units and plugs, and no HOAs yelling at me or anything. It is now perfect. I do have the fan on now because I'm hot as balls because I've been drilling and moving shit and all that kind of stuff, and why not? Big deal. I mean, I don't mind having the ceiling fan on, but I just want you to know how happy I am, and it's nice and cool in here, and you should be happy about that like I am. The only other thing that I wanted to talk about, and obviously I changed my outfit. That was all part of it. I don't know if I mentioned that. I did change my outfit to try to test this stuff by having something light on instead of having something dark on and seeing what everything looks like. And I think it looks great. I don't think I need to test how wonderful this camera with this Atomos Ninja 5 is. It's awesome. If you're looking for something to get, this combination, killer, killer. You won't regret it. All right. Enough of that. So just wanted to talk about why I'm wearing a different outfit after I said I only wear the same outfit every day. And I just put this on for the video. This changes some settings around, changed some lighting around. I'm good to go. Everything looks fantastic. This is the way it's going to be for a while. Knock on wood. Work project is all but done. And you might have heard, because I didn't turn the volume down on the computer, you might have heard that email. That's probably what I've been waiting for. So my project will be done. Again, changed the lighting around in here and all that kind of stuff. And ordered the rest of the power for the build out on this cinema rig that I have been dreaming of for 10 years. And I'll be done. We'll get a video going. I'll show you all that. And it's hot as balls outside and pleasantly cool in here. And I am one happy monkey. That's all I got for you today. Thanks for joining me, as always. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.